Today's episode of Inside Gaming Daily is brought to you by Omaha Steaks. If you go to omahasteaks.com and use the code INSIDE, you can get the favorite gift package for only $69.99.
Hey everyone, welcome back to Inside Gaming Daily for Monday!
Our favorite day of the week.
I love hearing Brian clap over there. It always sounds mildly dirty.
It sounds dirty, but that screen is looking mighty fine.
I'm still a dirty boy at heart.
You might have heard that things aren't so good for Anthem these days.
Wow, that is completely new information to me. I definitely haven't ever heard that once, especially not on this channel. What a strange, wacky world we're living in.
Anthem on Inside Gaming? Its player base is down to almost nothing. Most of its leadership is left, leading many to assume that BioWare is going to take that game out back and put it out of its misery.
Wow, this is a completely new assumption to me, and certainly not one that this paragon of gaming journalism Inside Gaming has ever once made. No way, no how, we are better than that. Damn it!
But we still do have to talk about this, because according to a new report, BioWare is still not giving up on the troubled online shooter, and it's actually got big plans for the game this time.
Alright, so we're eating a little bit of crow for our last Anthem video, and you're all welcome to point and laugh, but still, this is
really I wonder who writes these things,
You'll suck.
But still, this is all actually kind of cool news.
Yeah, Kotaku's Jason Schreier reported that BioWare is planning a complete overhaul of the game, citing three people familiar with the plans.
So yeah, Jason Schreier, big fan of the show, interviewed, three people, and it's being referred to by some people, this new version, as Anthem 2.0 or Anthem Next, which sounds like a pretty clear reference to the latest incarnation of another game that had a rocky start, No Man's Sky. So they're hoping Anthem will be the next No Man's Sky.
Is that something you should aspire to? I don't really know.
No, it's not.
Sounds pretty ambitious, with Kotaku saying that most of its systems, including its world and mission structure, and its loot, will all change big time.
One example that Kotaku gave was separating the game's map into segments instead of one big continuous map, and also possibly getting rid of the need to go back to Fort Tarsus after every mission.
Dink. God. Most details still seem very much in the air, with Kotaku saying that the developers haven't yet figured out exactly what it'll look like, of course.
You know what, they're flying by the seat of their pants still.
This sounds like how they built Anthem in the first place.
Yeah, exactly, they're like, you know what, we're gonna do the exact same thing and hope that it turns out differently.
There's like one engineer that's like, hey, can we like just drive it like a cruising speed? And the captain's like, no, ludicrous speed.
So the core ideas will still be there. You'll still be a freelancer flying around in your little exosuit, blasting around like a little Iron Man, but everything else seems to be on the table.
Yeah, the revamp of Anthem is reportedly being done out of BioWare's Austin studio, which would make sense, considering that it had a lot more experience working on online games like Star Wars The Old Republic.
You know, actually, Austin does have a rep for online games going all the way back to games like Ultima Online and stuff like that, so we're known as an MMO town up in here.
That's cool.
Damn, ATX.
Okay.
A little history for you kids.
But as of now, they said there are people in both Austin and BioWare's Edmonton studio working on the reboot.
Now, the question is, can this report be believed? None of Kotaku's sources would say this on the record, but it doesn't mean that it's wrong either.
Oh, what's happening? The light is flashing.
That has not happened to me since elementary school, when like the fire alarm would go off, and it was and I was just like,
uh-oh. So what has BioWare said about this in the past, Brian?
Yeah, I mean, in fairness to BioWare, they've always said publicly they're not going to abandon Anthem despite its many, many issues. You might remember EA CEO Andrew Wilson said back in May that they are committed to supporting Anthem over the long term, EA, of course, being BioWare's parent company. Since then, top BioWare folks said pretty much the same thing.
You did misread that quote ever so slightly, Brian. It's supposed to be committed to supporting Anthem over the long term. Yeah, in September, BioWare GM Casey Hudson wrote in his blog that they have a big team working on Anthem in both their Austin and Edmonton offices. Information we've already covered just minutes ago. But then again, you know, what else are they gonna say? This game sucks and we're dumping it?
We did reach out to an EA representative today who said they had no comment on the Kotaku report. So if it's true that BioWare's rebooting Anthem, this would run counter to a lot of really bad headlines for the game. Again, I've never heard of any of these bad Anthem headlines.
A game released in February and had a pretty rough launch, buggy gameplay, not enough things to do, and other issues that led players to feel like they bought a game that just wasn't finished.
The player base has long since evaporated, BioWare completely abandoned its content roadmap, and there were some high-profile departures that made it look like nobody was in charge of the game.
Ghost Ride the Anthem. Mm.
Oh, that was really good.
Thanks. Back in May, BioWare Director of Live Services Chad Robertson tweeted that they were 100% committed to Anthem, and we're looking forward to showing players the new content we're working on.
What did Chad Robertson add along with that, Brian?
Chad, in addition to taking all the good-looking girls, added that along with with lead producer Ben Irving and I. We've got a big team between Austin and Edmonton focused and motivated for improving the game. We appreciate your support and for being on this journey with us. And both of those dudes have since left the company.
Chad Anthem versus Virgin Inside Gaming.
The clash of the century.
Incel home Inside Gaming.
So we know that Anthem wasn't very well done, but you know what can be well done?
Me. Well, you don't, I don't want it well done. It depends on your taste.
I mean, if you're Trump, you want it well done with ketchup.
With ketchup.
Yeah. A real man's man.
The season Omaha Steaks is sharing an amazing limited time offer with our listeners to get a jump on your holiday shopping. To go to omahasteaks.com and enter the code INSIDE in the search bar to order the favorite gift package. The gift all your friends and family will love for only $69.99. Order now and you'll get 4 6-ounce bacon-wrapped filet mignons. Dang, that's the good stuff. The most tender steak in the world, as it's known. 4 savory premium pork chops, 4 Omaha Steaks burgers, those are real good. 4 perfectly brown potatoes au gratin, as the French would say. 4 made from scratch caramel apple tartlets. Those are actually really good. I can speak from experience. And Omaha Steaks signature seasoning packet. Plus, only for our listeners, a free 6-piece cutlery set and cutting board. Who doesn't need another cutting board in their house? I'm down. All this delicious food plus the free cutlery set they'll enjoy for years to come for only $69.99. Every Omaha Steaks order is flash frozen, vacuum sealed, safely delivered in a cooler with dry ice and ready to cook. If you go to omahasteaks.com and use the code INSIDE, you can get the favorite gift package for only $69.99. This holiday season, jump on that meat train and give your family what they really love. Omaha Steaks. Back to you guys.
Thanks, Zach.
You don't typically have to completely overhaul games that are doing well, and it's not like BioWare hasn't abandoned games before. Mass Effect Andromeda released in March of 2017. It was a mess, and 5 months later, they said that there'd be no single-player DLC for the game. They were dunzo.
Granted, Mass Effect Andromeda wasn't a live service game like Anthem is, so we're kind of comparing apples and oranges, but it does show that BioWare will move on from a game when it underperformed.
Back to Anthem, based on the Kotaku article, it looks like they're looking at No Man's Sky as a model of how to come back from the dead, either from a series of big updates or possibly even as a new game.
There's so many examples of things that have more successfully come back from the dead. Like, Jesus?
It did only take 3 days.
Yeah, that's a hella good turnaround in this economy. No Man's Sky was kind of the OG Anthem. It launched in 2016 to a ton of expectations that the game really just didn't live up to. It initially had more than 212,000 concurrent users on Steam, but almost all of those fled the game.
Yeah, but what did the dev team keep doing, Brian?
They just kept working. They kept cranking out updates just over months and years, culminating in the game's next expansion last year. That ended up with a peak of nearly 100,000 Steam players, not quite as high as the initial peak, but it was still something. They kind of showed that they were committed to the game. They got it to where it needed to be.
Yeah, and it's good. I enjoyed Next, but you know, they still massively up the first part. And the MMORPG Final Fantasy XIV, which we must mention because Brian loves this game more than anything in the whole world.
There's still a billboard for that game outside of the Westfield Mall.
Are you kidding?
Oh yeah.
Huge billboard.
Yeah, it's the Shadowbringers. Yeah.
Yeah, they're back, baby. They're cranking out the content.
The only person who plays this game lives in Austin.
Right? I know. They should move that billboard directly above Brian's house. Final Fantasy XIV had a terrible launch, much like Anthem back in 2010. Fans hated it. Critics hated it. Square Enix took the highly unusual step of completely shutting the game down. It was that bad.
Yeah. And almost 3 years later, they released a version 2.0 of the game called A Realm Reborn, which was much, much better received.
Right, Brian?
It's good. Well, the weird thing with that is that they had already done an MMORPG, Final Fantasy XI. That was pretty good. I was a huge fan of that one, too. So it's like they put out 14 and everybody had high hopes and they completely screwed it up. So it was a whole weird situation. But yeah, another example of how you can come back from something like this. But it takes a long time.
So game camera bound from a terrible start. It's happened before, like Brian just said, although there are way more examples of games having a bad launch and then just completely dying.
Yeah, Anthem players, though, definitely deserve a game that lives up to the money they've invested in it. And over on the Anthem subreddit, people were cautiously optimistic about the news.
Yeah, user SaveTheQueen9 wrote, "I'm just gonna put aside my cynicism and I'll be hopeful for a change. Enough has been said about this game and I wanted to have a No Man's Sky moment. I hope this will get the overhaul it deserves."
Another user, ChaosBleeds91.
Oh!
cool.
These names get cooler and cooler every day we do this.
Scaring me.
Chaos Bleeds 91 wrote, I will absolutely return to Anthem if this overhaul creates the game everyone hoped it would be from the beginning, but I will not spend a single dime on this. I don't care if it's a paid expansion or new game altogether. You fooled me once, and I will not make that mistake again.
Fool Chaos Bleeds 91 twice, and you bleed.
Back to BioWare, this news about rebooting Anthem comes as many people thought the studio itself might actually be in long-term trouble.
Yeah, they've had back-to-back bombs with Anthem and Mass Effect Andromeda, but Kotaku says that they're going full speed ahead with not only Dragon Age 4, which has been reported, but that they're also in the early stages of developing a new Mass Effect game.
That's cool.
Ooh.
I hope it's just as broken, because that was hilarious.
I'm running very naturally. So there you go, both Anthem and BioWare apparently not dead.
Wow, I can't believe Inside Gaming, the place that I trusted the most, was wrong.
Sound the Anthem alarm for the last time.
Don't ever say that, because it's never the last time.
Welcome
to Inside Gaming. Anthem 6 is still not out yet.
Well, it's good that BioWare is apparently committed to fixing Anthem. They're also solving a problem they created, right, Brian?
Yeah, this is a situation that confirms people's worst fears about modern game development. Studios releasing a half-finished product and then either abandoning it or taking a long time to fix it.
Another commenter on the Anthem subreddit, Xavion15, summed it up pretty perfectly. I am glad for the game, but this is such a low point for games. Releasing a hyped-up AAA game when it obviously had no business ever coming out, only to have to do a complete overhaul all this time later.
Yikes.
I think we all speak for Xyflon 19.
That's the name.
We all say yikes.
Savion Glover was right. He brought in the Anthem noise and the Anthem funk.
Oh my god. Yeah, man, this kind of just left a bad taste in my mouth. I'm glad that they're like still trying to fix it, but at the same time, this is just tarnished for me now, because why would you ever release it like that? Because they know people are going to buy it, and they know people are going to continue to put money into it.
Who's going to jump on board with Anthem at this point? Like, who's going to be like, you know what? I'm gonna buy it now.
That's what people said about No Man's Sky, and that had a pretty big return. It definitely got me, even though I was like, they massively messed this up, but I wanna play it now because it looks dope.
Yeah, I mean, going back to No Man's Sky, while it was certainly a mess, that was Hello Games' first big game. Previously, their only games were a series of side-scrollers called Joe Danger.
Danger's my last name, actually.
Your last name's Joe Danger?
So we can cut them some slack for getting in over their heads.
BioWare definitely should have known better. They've been doing this forever, and they also have that sweet EA money, so.
That BioWare magic.
What's going on, guys? It's a bad look for the whole industry when you have respected developers like BioWare putting out games the same way I used to cram for a final in college. Stay up for 48 hours in a row, knock back shot after shot of some cavity-inducing energy drink, begin vibrating into another universe, black out, somehow come out the other end with a pile of complete bullshit. You pray your professor will buy. He doesn't, but he's still beaten down by life that he gives you a B. Which is a pretty apt analogy for Anthem, if you ask us.
See, I just used to upload corrupt files.
Hitting the door like, we are committed to this for the long term.
Hey everyone, thanks for joining our monthly stand-up meeting. I am extremely committed to Anthem in the long term.
As he's being lowered down into a lifeboat.
You guys got this. Right? You got it. Since then, top BioWare folks have continued to say that they're not going to abandon Anthem.
In September, BioWare...